Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's drama at the races. Death at half a length. Starring Greg Morris. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company. Also by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, Schenley Industries, Matus Wine, and International Harvester. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Honey, and nobody knows why. You're about to enter the world of horse racing, where the thoroughbred is king, and man is but to serve.
On the outside by a wrecked wind farm.
Sutton Krasny! Hey, anybody seen Krasny?
Down here, nobody.
Krasny, get your rear end out here.
Jim Howard, get out of this store.
You see this? I know you said it.
I don't know what you're raving about, Howard, but I've had enough of you. Howard, you're crazy. Help somebody.
All right. Break it up. Come on, Mr. Howard. Now stop it.
Krasny, get this madman out of here.
Madman? You've had a grudge against me for this whole season, Krasny. Now you're threatening to kill one of my horses.
Kill one of your horses?
What do you mean, Mr. Howard?
This. I bought a stock in Pleasure Honey store.
Let me see. Howard, scratch Pleasure Honey or she dies.
Let me see that. There's no signature. What makes you think this would be me?
Because you tried to buy that horse and you've been sore at me ever since.
Oh, Howard, take your empty head out of here.
Mr. Howard, this should be looked into. Aren't you running Pleasure Honey in the next race?
I am. Then I plan to have her win, Sutton. Remember that. Let's go, Hasman.
Jim, I know you and Krasny have been at one another, but there's nothing on this note to say it was him. Maybe it's just a crank.
No. Look at this.
Get out of Holly Hill or we'll ruin you.
Yeah, well, that came a couple of days ago in the mail. One might be a crank. Two's a threat.
Yeah, I can't disagree. Okay, I'll get some men posted. That is, unless you're thinking of scratching Pleasure Honey.
Oh, no. Nobody pushes Big Jim Howard around.
Scotch and soda, Mr. Howard. Anything else?
No. Here, boy.
Thank you, sir. Sure hope Pleasure Honey wins. I got some dollars riding on her.
Yes. Thanks.
Jim, I got men posted from the turn to the finish line.
Anything happens, your butt is in a sling. Turn the speaker up.
Then every day and sincerely on the rail. Going into the far turn, it's Pleasure Honey in front by 3/4 of a length. Lord Thomas is second by a head. King's Ransom third by a neck. Riley's Luck fourth by 2.5 lengths. High Hopes is fifth. Sincerely sixth on the outside. Then every day on the rail, High Hopes, and so soon. Around the turn, it's Pleasure Lady in front by a neck. King's Ransom is second by a length and a half. Lord Thomas third by a half length. Riley's Luck fourth by a half length. Every day is fifth by a half and so soon. Into the stretch. It's Pleasure Honey in front on the rail by a head. King's Ransom second by a length. Riley's Luck third on the outside by a length. Lord Thomas fourth. And every day on the rail. Now it's Riley's Luck in front. Pleasure Honey is second. And here comes So Soon on the outside. It's Riley's Luck So Soon. And wait, something's wrong. Pleasure Honey fell.
Halsman, I did it. I killed my horse.
Riley's Luck is the winner, followed by So Soon and King's Ransom. Pleasure Honey never got to the finish line. Looks like the horse never had a chance. Died instantly. Billy Bangle, the jockey, apparently
is
not hurt.
Get that car. What are you doing?
No picnic for us today.
Now, one minute you're listening to the horse race, and the next you think you're at Indy.
Now, that race may just have cost my company $100,000.
I'll get to the point, Doc. How did Pleasure Honey die?
Your horse was murdered, Mr. Howard, with this.
May I see that? Hey, that's evidence.
Who are you? That's all right, Lester. Jason Kelly. He's an insurance investigator.
You track security, Lester?
That's right.
He used to be, if I have anything to say about it.
We did the best we could, Mr. Howard. I don't see
how... That is rotten. They killed my horse right in front of your men. Explain that.
I'll see to the horse. Doc, let's get it in the truck. Mr. Kelly, may I have the dart?
Sure, sorry. You mind telling me how the horse was killed?
Oh, the vet thinks there's curare on the tip.
Thanks.
Is anyone going to introduce me?
Oh, I'm sorry. Lana Gregory, Jim Howard.
Miss Gregory, just a little upset at the moment.
Oh, I understand. You know who did it?
There's another owner, a guy named Sutton Krasny, who's been itching to put me out of business.
Any proof of that?
Just two letters I got.
Letters?
Yeah. Lester Hasman's got them. Both of them threatened to ruin me, and the last one warned. If I ran Pleasure Honey, they'd kill her. That horse was one of my favorites. I just hit it to lose her.
I understand. But there is one thing.
Oh, what's that?
From the looks of it, the company will have to pay off. And $100,000 is a lot of weeping money.
Jason, why did you do that to the poor man?
You mean about the money?
Well, yes. I thought it was mean.
Well, I'll tell you something. So did I. But I wanted to see his reaction.
And it seemed genuine to me. Besides, he was with the security man when the horse was killed.
Lovely lady, I never said he did it. I just follow my hunches. Now, you want to do a chore for me?
Sure. You, want to make me deputy sneak?
You always were. Go see the jockey, Billy Bangle.
And what?
I don't know. Ask him about what happened. Butter him up.
Oh, I do know how to do that.
Oh, I know. See you later.
Right.
Come in.
Hi. Is Billy Bangle here?
Oh, Lana Gregory?
Yes. Well, did somebody send a message ahead?
Oh, please come in. I'm sorry, but I am one of your biggest admirers. Figuratively speaking, anyway.
Well, thank you. Do you feel all right?
Fine. Lucky, I guess I didn't even get a bruise. Well, I'm really flattered you would even come and ask.
Well, to be truthful, I came with a friend, Jason Kelly. His company holds the insurance on Pleasure Honey.
Oh, I see. Well, it's still an honor. Would you sit down?
Thanks. Billy, have you been riding for Mr. Howard a long time?
Billy, it's Gregory. What are you doing here?
Oh, I just came to talk to Billy for a moment. Well, he took a bad fall.
Oh, sure, yeah. Well, you okay, Billy?
Oh, sure, Mr. Howard.
Are you going to feel like riding tomorrow?
Yes.
Good. Well, we'll see you at the ranch later on.
Yes, sir. I'm going out to the hospital, and then I'll be there about 7.
Okay. Give my best to your wife. My very best.
I will. Thank you.
Is your wife in the hospital, Billy?
Yes, she has been for almost a year.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, it's not something we can do much about. Say, you know, she just loves you. She's seen almost every one of your pictures.
Oh, I hope that's not what put her in the hospital.
You're even funnier in person.
Thanks. Say, I've got an idea. Jason is sure to be tied up for a couple of hours, and if you're going to the hospital, maybe your wife would like a visitor.
Oh, would you? Well, she'd love that.
Why not?
Tasman?
Oh, what can I do for you, Mr. Kelly?
Try Jason. Your secretary said I'd find you here.
Yeah, she'd give away state secrets if she ever had any. Yeah, let me wash away the track dust and we can talk.
Was Howard with you during the whole race?
Yep, all the time.
Well, you got any likely suspects?
One, but I'm just blowing smoke. A guy by the name of T.P.
T.P.? Who he?
Thomas Peterson, large-type bookie, does most of the business in town. Lays off plenty to the guys in the East. There's a rumor going around that Big Jim is into him for a bundle, so maybe he's putting the screws to Howard to get him to pay. Killing Pleasure Honey would be just the way to do it, too.
Yeah, maybe. But then again, Howard could have arranged to pick up the insurance and bail himself out.
Or Sutton Krasny could really hate Howard. You're going to need a basket to carry all your suspects in.
Oh, excuse me, Les. I know it's the men's room, but you got to come quick.
Why, what's wrong?
Mr. Howard, he's been shot.
Get that vet away from me. What do you think I am, some horse?
All right, Doc. Thanks, I'll give you a call later.
Okay, Lester.
What happened, Jim?
Oh, getting in my car when I heard a sort of a pop. And the next thing I knew, that dart was sticking to my shoulder. Well, it didn't hurt much, but whatever it did, it was a lousy shot.
Or maybe it was just a warning.
Could be. I got another of those notes.
If Sunshine Lady runs tomorrow, she dies.
Where was this?
On my windshield.
You gonna run Sunshine Lady tomorrow?
You better believe it. And don't you go thinking you can cancel a policy. I know my rights.
I wasn't thinking of that. But maybe some of our security people ought to come out. If that's all right with you, Les.
Yeah, sure. It's longer a check with me. How much you got Sunshine Lady insured for?
$500,000.
Jace, you can't suspect Jim Howard.
Now, what gives you that idea?
I know that look. He's too sweet a man. Do you know that Billy Bangle's wife will never get out of the hospital, and Jim Howard's been taking care of her bills this whole year?
No, I didn't. What's wrong with it?
Parkinson's disease. Oh, I feel so sorry for her. She's a very sweet lady.
Okay, okay. Case for Jim Howard dismissed. For now. Come on.
Where are we going?
I'm going to give you your next lesson in sleuthdom.
How exciting. Anyone ever tell you you're an exciting burglar?
Shh. Only the police. So let's hope they don't repeat the compliment. Okay?
You know, this is better than one of my old movies.
Don't I know it? Give me that key light of yours.
Hey, a little respect for a star, please. Here.
Now, where, here it is.
A typewriter? You dragged me out here to type?
Right. Take a letter.
Chauvinist pig. Okay. What?
Howard's threat note. Scratch, pleasure, honey, or die.
There. How'd I do?
Stick to acting.
Oh. Hey, you shouldn't do that. It's illegal.
I won't tell if you don't. Look at this.
Bunch of darts. Darts?
Let's get out of here.
Well, aren't you going to take them with you? It's evidence.
Nope. Doesn't prove anything except Sutton Krasny owns a dart gun.
That shoots darts just like the one that killed Pleasure, honey.
Sure, but it could have been a plant. What we have to do is prove it.
How?
By catching him in the act tomorrow at the race.
Where have you been?
I have been talking with the famous TP, Ace Bookie.
Did he do it?
Naturally not. Bookies seldom kill anybody, especially horses. What I have to do now is find Jim Howard, in case he tries to follow through.
Wait a minute. You think he did it?
Absolutely.
Well, you're right, in a way.
There they go. Happy Harry, going to the front.
What do you mean, in a way?
Come on. I want you to meet a friend of mine.
Going into the park, turn at sunshine.
Lily, this is Jason. Jason, Mrs. Bangle.
What?
She called me. Jason, it was Billy that killed Pleasure, honey. Wouldn't you?
But he's out there racing right now. He'll kill Sunshine Lady.
Maybe not, Mr. Kelly.
Your maybe might cost me $500,000, Mrs. Bangle.
Oh, Jay, shut up and enjoy the race. Come on, Sunshine Lady!
Sunshine Lady on the rail by a head, easy goer, second by a light. Happy Harry, third on the outside, then Pretty Day and Mother Mine. Now on the rail is Sunshine Lady and Easy Go. Coming down the wire, it's Sunshine Lady and Easy Go. Sunshine Lady and Easy Go, head and head. And Sunshine Lady is the winner by a nose. We'll have the official results in just one moment.
All right, you scared the hell out of me. You happy?
Sure. I just won. Come on, Let's go down to Billy's office, and Lily and I will explain everything.
You see, Mr. Kelly, Billy did it for me. Howard told him that if he killed Pleasure Honey, he would continue to pay my hospital bills.
Lily, I couldn't.
I know, dear. That's why I asked Miss Gregory to bring me. I just knew you wouldn't.
So there wasn't any gun, was there? You placed the dart yourself.
Yes. But I knew I couldn't do it a second time.
Jason, you mean you knew?
Not till just now. I figured Howard must have sent himself the notes and planted the darts in Sutton's office.
Well, what's that?
That should be Sutton Krasny taking his pound of flesh. Shall we see?
Howard, get your horses up this raceway. I don't ever want to see you again. Hey, Kelly,
you did this.
Nope. You did it yourself. I just let Sutton know.
I'll get you for this.
Forget it, Howard. You've lost the horse. But since the company doesn't have to pay, we won't file charges.
No charges?
No. But you want a big purse today. Make sure you share it with Billy.
Yeah.
And there's something else.
What?
Find yourself another insurance company.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Death by Havilene is an original radio drama by Keith Watkins. Greg Morris was heard as Jason Kelly. Featured in the cast were Julie Bennett, Lou Krugman, Harry Henson, Jerry Hausner, and Byron Kane. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Coates, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley B. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.